Congratulations, Ashwaju, Bola, Ahmed, Tinubu. I want to thank God for your life. I want to appreciate God for you. And I want to say at 65, you have done well. You are a leader, an outstanding leader in Yoruba land and beyond. We are happy that you are strong and you are representing the Yoruba nation well. I am saying this to let you know that issues in Nigeria goes beyond party lines. I am not a member of your party and I will never be, but you deserve to be celebrated. Congratulations and many happy returns.
By the time, because of road repair, but infrastructure and so on, so by the time we are going back and taking the same time, what we are going through now will be resolved. We are going through a historical phase of a country that is promising and holding a promise for you. There's a leadership on the line. And you have to live with that for now. Protest will solve the problem. Will it?
Sir, what is going to solve the problem?
The problem is replanning. Be responsive. Be able to get engaged with you. So that you will see the problem that we are facing. That's it.
But sir, don't you think you are leaders have failed us?
Now,
please hold on. Please, we are talking. Ashwaju appeals to us whenever we want to vote. Kindly hold on. This is a dialogue between the youth.
I'm getting into this debate.
Okay. Sir, I'm so sorry.
When I'm tired, I cut off.
Okay, sir.
What is your question?
No, sir. We are here.
Yes.
We've held on to a lot of promises from the change agenda.
Yes.
We believed that the leader, President Buhari, was going to come here, was going to come on board and change our lives. We believed in a system that would provide regular 24-hour power supply. We believed in a system where the health system, the health structure would bring,
commendable changes.
Commendable change. People like Nasa.
Poor people would be able to have the medical care.
I remember during the campaign promise.
Since the beginning of this administration, there's a lot of unemployment. Massive sack in the banking industry.
Excuse me. You are right about the term. In every political situation, you have the twist and turn. It cannot be straight all the time. We are the same victim. You carry a placard. I've been a placard carrier since when? This government is a product of a protest. If you didn't have a bad administration, then you won't vote for us.
Very true.
You voted on our promise.
Very well, sir.
We are just 2 years into that promise compared to 16 years. That they took over, that they could have made the changes. Yes, they are working on the electricity. Without electricity, there could be no industrialization and explosion of employment opportunity for our people. That is in our head. But it cannot grow like a mushroom to fetch a water out of the rock, you have to endure some blisters. Be patient. Have the hope that is this second. Let's have faith in this. Touch them every time that we perceive any hardship. We will not have a stable and consistent leadership in the country. We've continued to manage Lagos. You've seen progress.
Yes.
It's because of the consistent Lagos application of our blueprint. There was a time started in 1998-99. It was a terrible situation here in Lagos. Dead body on the street, no ambulances. Last week was completely disintegrated. Extremely dangerous mortuaries. What do you have today? Because you endure then, just go and endure again. We sold APC to you. Please hang on to it. No, you have your right to vote against us during the election if you want, but I remain in the party. Because we will retool this party. We will retool this government. A damage of over 60 years and 60 years of misgovernance cannot be turned around overnight. Let's be patient. Let's have the understanding. Let's hang on to hope. There is nothing more effective that can drive you, better than hope and belief in a positive turn of this situation. We understand. We are not saying you are not suffering. We are not saying unemployment has not increased. I have no argument. But economy cannot collapse one day. This is a systemic problem that occurred before now. Fine. We are not running away from that responsibility. We are going to face it squarely, and we are going to bring prosperity back to the country.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Sir,
can we make a demand now?
Can we make a demand?
The demand is this. If you look around, Nigerians are collecting what I term as negative salary. The prices of goods items in the market, they are times three now. Yet the salaries and wages remain the same. Even at the same time, most say they are going over 8 months salary. The burden of the current situation, sir, is on masses. And what our demand now is this. Public office holders, they should slash their wages and income. Or whatever
employment they are collecting.
To make the body to work across the board.
Excuse me.
It's not fair enough.
It's not fair.
Excuse me. You've contradicted yourself. You said the salary they are taking is not enough. Isn't it? Because of inflation. If you slash those salaries,
The salaries of
public holders, what are we talking about? Salaries of the legislative makers to be slashed. Our lawmakers.
The lawmakers, especially, what they are collecting is outrageous.
It's too much. If truly our president, look at our budget, 265 million.
They can go a long way.
Look at our budget.
You are making sense.
Yes.
We look at those problems. Go and write them out.
We have written them down. And that's why we are here to present the letter to you.
Thank you very much.
On behalf of youth.
Thank you.
And sir, we are actually appealing to you. Remember, you made a promise to us that you to be much more involved in governance.
You will be.
But how long, sir? I read one of your historic books, sir. You said power would not serve that lacquer.
Yeah,
and sir, we want to have a dialogue with you. I remember I met Mr.
I will arrange an opportunity for a more auspicious time. You don't know whether I'm going to my farm now that I dress like this. You don't know whether I'm going to any other place. No, I'm not this casual, and I'm not going for gym or anything. I'm going to my guess. When we have time, we will see that.
Sir, we leave you with this message. Friend. We will not relent. We will not relent in making our voices known. I will keep on putting up the government right. on their toes it's to work on right. because it's we have been demanding.
It's your right to protest.
What is it?
It's your right to protest. Any misgovernance, any perceived bad treatment, no one should stop you. No one. Okay? However, if you get engaged, you don't have to suffer the burning sun. I've given you the respite that you deserve.
Thank you very much. We appreciate your. Thank you very much. We appreciate your presence. We'll go back. And
go back. Calm down. I'm going to whoop. Visit me whenever it's necessary. The job will be available.
But sir, we've been put away. We were pushed and pushed by your security guard. And they need to turn down and apologize to us. To push us? To push us? When during elections and campaign, you always beg us. You dance for us. You always put shame. You call Atiyah and dare for us. We should not be pushed now. And sir, we refuse. An apology has to be tendered to us, sir.
Listen. Listen. You put me here. Right?
Yes.
Your boots.
Yes. You believe in you. Lagos now, was work. Lagos me. Is working.
Excuse me. Now, these people, I put them there because I want to feel secure.
Oh, sorry.
If they just open the door to anybody, anyhow, say placard, what about, you are good people. What about the evils that can sneak in among you? If I leave myself exposed, I don't have a body armor. Anybody can attach a bomb to their body in these days.
But sir, it feels that people are leaders are innocent.
Now,
they shouldn't be scared.
They didn't see you. They have to see their security, the security of the man they are there to protect.
Are we going to keep
so
having
if I apologize, I just apologize a phony apology.